Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome, man. Welcome to Beyond Classic Rock. I got a complimentary quad coming your way, man. And this is what I'm calling a folk bluegrass mix, man. We're going to start with Dave Rollins' Machine with John Paul Jones doing Going to California, followed by Gabby Marino live from here with Chris Tile, a song called La Malaguena. Followed by Peter Rowan and Tony Rice. They're at the Suwannee Spring Fest in 2005 doing Cold, Rain, and Snow. And then finally, I'm With Her. They're live from Hair Radio Show, Telluride Bluegrass Festival, doing Hannah Hunt. It's a Vampire Weekend cover. So, man, before I pop this off, I just want to give a shout out and thanks to Jack Serra. Thanks very much for the recommendation. Thanks for the variety that you guys are giving us on this platform. It's really appreciated, man. So, first up, Dave Rollins' Machine with John Paul Jones, Going to California. And no doubt, Jonesy is going to be playing mandolin. I heard he can sing, but I've never heard him sing. Okay, man. So, Dave Rollins' Machine, Going to California. Let's get it. That's Gillian Welsh, right? Dave Rollins. It just clicked in my mind. They're married now, I think. Thank you.
try to find a woman who's never, never been before. Standing on a hill in the mountain of dreams, telling myself it's not as hard, hard, hard as it
Jonesy's always looks so good, so youthful. Is it just me, or Dave Rollins for some reason reminds me of John Phillips from the Mamas and the Papas? Maybe it's just the height, the hat, and the way he stands with the guitar. It's just these flashes in my mind. I don't know if he looks like, but he reminds me of. Do you know what I'm talking about? I just have this image of John Phillips with the Mamas and the Papas. You know, there's three of them standing doing the harmonies, and then he's there with the guitar. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's a combination of the height, the guitar in hand, and the hat. You know, great singer, great voice, good harmonies. A couple of months ago, I did a reaction for Gillian Welch. And you should check that out. And Dave was in the mix too. There was some live stuff. There was once an album and then there was a quad. And so he was a part of that. I think they're a couple now, or they're married now. All right, so let's do this, man. Dave Rollins Machine, John Paul Jones. That was excellent. So first, Dave Rollins. Dave Rollins Machine. David Todd Rollins is an American guitarist, singer, and record producer. He is known for his partnership with singer and songwriter Gillian Welch. He and Welch were nominated for the Academy Award for Best Original Song at the 91st Academy Awards for When a Cowboy Trades His Spurs for Wings, from the Ballad of Buster Scruggs. Rollins attended the Berklee College of Music and studied with Lauren Passarelli. He produced albums by Gillian Welch, Willie Watson, Dawes, and Old Crow Medicine Show. He leads the Dave Rollins Machine with Gillian Welch, Willie Watson, Paul Coore, and Brittany Haas. John Paul Jones of Led Zeppelin has been known to play mandolin with the band occasionally. His vocal style has often been compared to that of Bob Dylan. Rollins achieved his signature guitar sound flat picking a small arc-type guitar. The 1935 Epiphone Olympic, that has been his primary instrument, was a mid-place guitar for its time, with a carved archetype solid spruce wood top, carved archetype solid mahogany back, and mahogany sides. It sold about $35 in 35, equivalent to $660 in 2020. Rollins scavenged the guitar from his friend's garage and is now hardly seen playing anything else. As he states, "I just picked it up, it was filthy, and it didn't have strings. You could just see the shape of it under the sawdust." Rollins had a new one-piece bridge made for it and brought it to the recording sessions for the Welch first record. As soon as, this is him, quote, "As soon as I heard it through the microphone and through the speakers, I was like, I'm in love with this guitar." Unquote. All right, and there you go, a match made in heaven. Right on. Good signature sound. He can certainly play the hell out of that thing, man. All right, so let's hit up our next track, man. And that being La Malaguena. That's Gabby Moreno. All right. La Malaguena, Gabby Moreno. Let's get it.
Debajo de esas dos cejas, qué bonitos ojos tienes. Ellos me quieren mirar, pero si tú no los dejas, pero si tú no los dejas, ni siquiera parpadear. Niña salerosa, besar tus labios quisiera, besar tus labios quisiera. Hechicera, como el candor de una rosa.
I'm gonna have to get some lyrics up.
Yo te concedo razón, yo te concedo razón, si por pobre me desprecias. Yo no te ofrezco riquezas, te ofrezco mi corazón, te ofrezco mi corazón a cambio de mí.
That was excellent. What a fantastic artist, holy cow. Great singer, she can hold that note. Very, very nice, man. Never heard of this lady. Okay, Gabby Marino. Well, that's, I'm gonna have to get up some English lyrics, see and understand what she's singing about, and go from there. But let's focus on the artist specifically more so than song detail, especially when it's an artist that I have not known about or heard of previously. It's more fitting to focus on the artist rather than on the song detail. We can always follow up with music or maybe in following reactions of stuff. So, Gabby Marino. Maria Gabriela Marina Bonella, professionally known as Gabby Marino, is a Guatemalan singer, songwriter, and guitarist. Her music ranges from blues, jazz, soul, R&B. Marina sings in English, Spanish, French, and Portuguese. Wow. She became known to broader audiences in Latin America after recording a song with Ricardo Arjona in 2011 called Fuiste Tú. In 2013, she recorded covers of the popular songs Kiss of Fire and The Weed Smoker's Dream with Hugh Laurie for his album Didn't It Rain. On numerous occasions, beginning in October of 2016, she performed with Chris Tile on Live From Here, giving her greater recognition among American listeners. Sorry, my damn throat. Some of her popular covers include Amapola and No Soy El Air. Man, I can't read this shit. Gabby Marina's soulful vocals and ability to switch languages and genres have made her a rising star. And this is a review by NPR, All Things Considered. A rising star, All Things Considered. The Guatemalan singer-songwriter Gabby Marino plucked ragtimey syncopations on a well-worn acoustic guitar and let loose a tangy, bluesy voice with the feistiness of Edith Piaf, the New York Times. Yeah, holy cow, they've got a whole bunch of critics giving their one or two sentence inserts of praise. There's a whole lot of them here. Marino's breathtaking voice is passionate and stylistically malleable as she glides back and forth easily between bossa nova and bluesy rock, NPR Tiny Desk's concerts. And yeah, it just keeps going, man. Let me read one more. Our little secret is neither little nor secret anymore. On illustrated songs, influences of soul and Spanish ballads explode in a synergy of musical pieces that impeccably represent a young artist with a rich, old soul. And that's from Al Borg, music critic. Yeah, and they just have a whole slew of stuff about her that is really, really all positive and very good, man. So, let us hit up our next track, man. Cold, Rain, and Snow. That's Peter Rowan and Tony Rice. And Jack has a note here about the song. Jack says, "This next song serves as an intro to Peter Rowan and a belated tribute to the late Tony Rice. This performance is a good example of what the father of bluegrass, Bill Monroe, would have called the ancient tones." All right, man. Peter Rowan, Tony Rice, Cold, Rain, and Snow. Let's get it. Thank you. a lot of hair Tony's got. Man.
Out in the
long jam. Over 9 minutes.
Thank you, folks. It's good to see all our friendly, familiar Florida faces here. And some new faces, too. For those of you who have not been here, this happens every few years.
We
have a survivalist camp here, and as well as music. And everybody pulls together, and we have a wonderful time. And I want to thank you for being part of it. The father of bluegrass music was Bill Monroe, and this is a song that I got to write with him when I was a bluegrass boy.
Okay. Wow, that was great, man. Really, really nice. Nice, long, extended jam. Just taking turns, doing their thing. Good harmony with the lady there. Good song, man. Good stuff. Peter Rowan, Tony Rice. Cold, Rain, and Snow. I've heard this song before, but I can't tell you who the singer was, whether it was even a lady or a gent. But I know that I've heard this tune before. So, let's do this, man. Let's just do a little read on Peter and then on Tony. So, Peter Rowan is an American bluegrass musician and composer. Rowan plays guitar and mandolin, yodels, and sings. From an early age, he had an interest in music and learned to play guitar from his uncle. He formed the rockabilly band The Cupids in 1956. Influenced by the blues musician Eric Von Schmidt, Rowan traded his electric guitar for an acoustic and began to play the blues. He was also influenced by the folk sound of Joan Baez. In college, he discovered bluegrass after hearing The Country Gentleman and the Stanley Brothers. He soon discovered the music of Bill Monroe, and with help from banjo player Bill Keith, he was invited to Nashville to audition for Monroe. Accompanied by Keith, Rowan went to Nashville and was hired in 63 and 64 as a songwriter, rhythm guitarist, and lead vocalist of Monroe's Bluegrass Boys. His recording debut as a bluegrass boy took place October 14, 1966, and he recorded a total of 14 songs with Monroe, including the classic Walls of Time, co-written with Monroe before his tenure ended in the spring of 67. In 97, Rowan received a Grammy Award for his contributions to the bluegrass compilation True Life Blues, the songs of Bill Monroe. The album won for Best Bluegrass Album that year. He has also received 6 Grammy nominations throughout his career. Rowan received the Bluegrass Star Award, presented by the Bluegrass Heritage Foundations of Dallas, Texas, on October 20, 2012. The award is bestowed upon bluegrass artists who do an exemplary job of advancing traditional bluegrass music and bringing it to new audiences while preserving its character and heritage. Right on. Very notable gent. Tony Rice. David Anthony Rice. June 8, 1951, December 25, 2020. Known professionally as Tony Rice, was an American guitarist and bluegrass musician. He was an influential acoustic guitar player in bluegrass, progressive bluegrass, newgrass, and acoustic jazz. He was inducted into the International Bluegrass Hall of Fame in 2013. Rice's music spans the range of acoustic from traditional bluegrass to jazz-influenced new acoustic music to songwriter-oriented folk. Over the course of his career, he played alongside J.D. Crow and the New South David Grisman during the formation of Dog Music. And Jerry Garcia as well, led to his own Tony Rice unit, collaborated with Norman Blake, recorded with his brothers Wyatt, Ron, and Larry, and co-founded the Bluegrass Album Band. He recorded with drums, piano, soprano, sax, as well as with traditional bluegrass instrumentation. Rice's singing voice was a distinctive baritone. Yet sad we never got to hear him sing. In 94, he was diagnosed with a disorder known as muscle tension dysphonia, and as a result, was forced to stop singing in live performances. Rice's 2013 induction into the International Bluegrass Hall of Fame reportedly was the last time he played guitar in public due to the lateral epicondylitis that affected his ability to play in his last years. Yeah, sad. Sad that happens to a great artist. I heard that Linda Ronstadt as well. I believe, was it Parkinson's she's suffering from? That she hasn't got the ability to sing anymore. Can you imagine? A great, great voice like that. Yeah, rest in peace, Mr. Tony Rice. So, let's check out our final track, man. And that is I'm With Her. And they're live from Hair Radio Show, Telluride Bluegrass Festival, doing Hannah Hunt, a Vampire Weekend cover. That's a long-ass intro, isn't it? Jack, why did you have to make this intro so long, man? All right. So, I'm not going to read all that again. Let's just say, let's get it.
And it gives me the greatest, greatest pleasure to introduce you to I'm With Her.
Shot of the crowd there.
The gardener told me some plants move, but I could not believe it. Till me and Hannah Hunt saw crawling vines and weeping willows as we made our way from Pride to Phoenix. A man of faith said hidden eyes could see what I was thinking. I just smiled and told him that was only true of Hannah, and we glided on through Waverly. Days were long, our nights no longer. Count the seconds, watching hours. Though we live on the US dollar, you and me, we got our own sense of time. Thank you.
be great being there. Nice outdoor festival. Listening to these great singers. That was awesome.
That's a Vampire Weekend song.
Very nice. Very nice. Who is this dude that we're looking at here? He seemed very, very jubilant in the end. Great song, man. Excellent, excellent band. They're really, their harmony is just off the charts. And wow, you know, being able to harmonize, stay on point, not only play an instrument, but the violin, damn, man, that is challenging, let me tell you. I haven't seen too many people playing that shit and singing at the same time. All right, so, again, what we'll do here is we'll focus on the artist rather more so than song information. Whenever, especially it's a new artist I'm being introduced to, I like to focus just on the artist for the first time. So, I'm With Her are an American band consisting of singer-songwriters and multi-instrumentalists Sarah Watkins, violin, guitar, and ukulele, Sarah Jarosz, banjo, mandolin, octave mandolin and guitar, and Ife O'Donovan, guitar and keyboards. In 2020, their song, Call My Name, received nominations for 2 Grammy Awards, Best American Roots Performance and Best American Roots Song, winning the latter. History. When Sarah Jarosz was 9, she met Sarah Watkins at a festival. Both of them grew up with bluegrass music. Jarosz began playing the mandolin when she was 10, and Ife Donovan noticed her when she was 15. O'Donovan said about Jarosz, quote, "You were this amazing young person. You just had so much confidence and skill, but you were never like, look at me, I'm so good, and I'm so young. You know, you always seemed like a peer." Nice. Watkins, Jarosz, and O'Donovan started collaborating at a workshop at the 2014 Talaroo Bluegrass Festival, where they had been asked to sing together. They performed for the first time at the January 2015 Celtic Connections Festival in Scotland and continued to tour in Europe. In mid-2015, they wrote songs together for 4 days in LA, where Watkins lives. In December that year, they wrote for 8 days at a farmhouse in Vermont with a hot tub and a wood-burning fireplace, surrounded by snow and near a barn with horses. Taking in that nice rustic setting just to get the creative juices flowing. The group began using the phrase, I'm With Her, as their tour name in early 2015. The phrase was later adopted by the 2016 Hillary Clinton presidential campaign, unrelated to the band. I remember that. At the 67th Grammy Awards on January 26, 2020, I'm With Her won the award for Best American Roots Song for their recording of Call My Name. The song was co-written by Jarosz, Watkins, and O'Donovan. All right, man. And that is the wiki information given for I'm With Her. A really, really talented bunch of ladies, man. Fantastic sound. I could listen to them sing all day. Could you imagine, man, being at that festival? And they're the main feature, and you're sitting there all afternoon in that really nice venue listening to them. You know, sucking back the booze of your choice and chilling, you know. Probably grazing in the pasture of happy grass too, you know. Outdoor festivals, let me tell you. All right. So that concludes our look at this excellent quad. Really good assembly of talent here, Jack. Good assembly of songs. And introducing me to a couple of new people. Thanks very much for that. Love this platform for the variety that keeps coming. It's fantastic. All right. So, what I got coming up, I got a couple of reactions, a few new patrons, CSN, Jeffrey, Rob, Marco, got reactions for you folks. And I just finished doing a reaction to a very, very interesting topic. Excuse my damn throat today. Too much sugarcane rum, it dries you out. Yeah, I was listening, or I was checking out a reaction the other day. It's a documentary. Why is modern music so awful? And it's very, very interesting, man. It hits a couple of things right on the head, I think. And I was taken to task by a couple of people afterwards for my commentary. And, oh man, one person wrote me this long-ass letter talking about how ignorant I am and, you know, the hallmark of your character is underlined and laced with ignorance and, you know, you should shut your stupid mouth and all kinds of stuff. So needless to say, it was very, very stirring for some people. And but thank you very much ahead of time for some of you who have actually checked it out and didn't, you know, create shit in the comment sections like I asked. It could easily have turned into a pissing contest, but as far as I can tell, it hasn't. But it didn't stop some people from private messaging me, though. Anyway, man, hey, it's all good. You know, my opinion is my opinion. If you don't like it, that's okay. If you do like it, that's okay as well. So, yeah, check that out. I think that you'll really like it, especially if you can relate to a lot of people's frustrations about modern music, where it is, where it's going, and, you know, just how everything sounds so much the same, without soul, without heart, without substance, without timbre, you know. So I think that it's very, very influential, and this documentary, even though it was only 20 minutes, it really, really taught us quite a lot, I think. So check it out, man, if you've got the time. All right, so that is my look at this excellent folk/bluegrass quad. Thank you again, Jack. I appreciate it. Apologize to you, Jack, because I've been running a week late. Thanks for not jumping on my ass about it, like some patrons have. Where's mine? Where's mine? Where's mine? It's been a week. It's been a week. Where is it? Where is it? Holy shit. So, Jack, you're the shit. Thank you very much for not doing that. And some of my patrons who've been with me a while, they understand that sometimes I run late. Life happens. So thank you to you who have been patient and not been jumping on me about it. So, with that said, there was something else I was going to say. Oh, yeah. Just basically what's coming up. You know, there's a mixture of all kinds of things coming up, from a little bit more folk to some progressive stuff to some punk stuff. And then I know that there's some Motown stuff. Is it Motown? Well, it's got that kind of signature sound, some early Stevie Wonder. And but I do know that there is something with the Funk Brothers. So I'm going probably a couple of weeks into time, you know. I mean, when people send me their recommendations, I kind of get to see the idea of what it is. And that's about it, you know. And then weeks later, then I open mine. So I'm just going on that faint memory, you know what I mean? But basically, point being is that there's a great amount of variety that you can expect, especially over, I'd say, in the next 2 weeks. So I'm looking forward to that, man. The variety exchange is fantastic. Anyways, you guys have a good one. Hope you enjoyed this. Take care. I'll catch you in another reaction. Peace.